So, that was fun. Going in, I guess. Maybe. Alright, so descending is pretty good. It's a little rougher than the big Hanzo. That could be because it's such a short chain stay. Feels like I put the rear wheel wherever I wanted. Climbing, I think, might be a little issue with the short chain stays and the taller fork, but we'll see. Trust leaves. Sneaky, hiding stuff. Loose. Thank you. well. The Hanzo ST frame with the big Hanzo parts. Is not as stable, I guess. Well, no, it is stable. Just not as burly, I guess you could say, as the big Hanzo's geometry. However, this frame, the Hanzo ST frame, steel frame with the big Hanzo parts and the rear wheel tucked all the way in, extremely playful. I like that. I am a little more over the front end though because of the geometry. So because of that, I might opt for the big Hanzo ST frame instead, but I would still put 140 mil travel on either one of these frames. Just because 140 would be really nice. And so far, the issue I thought I would have on this frame, because it is made for 29er wheels, which are slightly taller than the 27.5 plus, of pedal strike issues so far have not been an issue at all. But a lower center of gravity and much, much shorter wheelbase is impressive. Really, really playful. How you doing? It's clear behind me. Easy to kind of hop it around. It reminds me a lot of my dirt jumper I used to have, which was always fun. Should have aired up the front fork a little bit because of the slightly steeper geometry. I'm over the front end just a little bit more, just a half degree, but I might be going through the travel a little bit faster on this frame with the pressure I use on the big Hanzo. This frame has a 68 degree head angle. Big Hanzo is a 67.5, so it's not a huge difference, but it is there. But I would say I kind of like the feel of this frame over the big Hanzo frame so far. And it's probably due to the stiffer rear triangle, shorter stays, steel frame, really beefed up chain stays and flattened seat stays, that this frame feels significantly stiffer at the pedals than the alloy big Hanzo does. That's probably a mixture of everything. The big Hanzo feels a little less jarring, I guess you could say, but that's also got a longer wheelbase than this one does, which is probably the deciding factor of that being an issue, because this bike has a as-is 1163 wheelbase, where the big Hanzo is like 2000. What is it? it's a difference. It's a big difference. Yeah, that's a couple inches on the wheelbase. And then the rear wheel is tucked in another 15 millimeters or so from what the big Hanzo comes with, so I'll have to get the numbers for you. They're on Facebook. So I am out here riding at Sansom Park. This is part of their waterfall area. I am riding a hodgepodge of parts. I had stripped down the 2020 Big Hanzo that I had reviewed previously and swapped the frame for the 2020 Hanzo, the Kona Hanzo ST frame. Not the Big Hanzo, but the Hanzo, which the Hanzo does fit 27.5 plus wheels. I have the rear wheel tucked all the way forward. It has a significantly shorter wheelbase than the Big Hanzo does, at least on the alloy. I am running a 130 millimeter travel fork on this bike. This frame set was made for 29-inch wheels, but I decided we already had the frame at the shop. I was debating on doing a Big Hanzo ST frame set for myself, but since we already have it, and I like to change it up, I decided to try it out. My biggest concern with this frame, because the bottom bracket drop is, I believe, 15 millimeters lower on the Hanzo versus the Big Hanzo, because of 29-inch wheels. Because of that, with these, the 27.5 plus wheels, they are slightly smaller than the 29-inch wheels by about a half inch at the, between this, about an inch for the whole thing. So about half inch from the top to, from the bottom to the middle of the axle. So that dropped my bottom bracket height from roughly 305 millimeters on the Big Hanzo, supposed to be 310, to 295 millimeters on this frame set. So I was concerned with possibly hitting my pedals on stuff, which so far has not been an issue. I used to hit my pedals a lot on some of the Cannondales I had, but those were also all full suspension. So this being a hardtail, as long as I keep my pedals in the right spot and watch where I'm pedaling at, watch my lines, I shouldn't have an issue. But so far, it's pretty good. The head tube angle is a little bit steeper. It is an 80 degree head angle on the Hanzo ST versus the Big Hanzo's 67.5 degree. So it does make the fork a little bit steeper. So I am a little bit over the front versus the Big Hanzo. I am over the back wheel more, which makes this bike extremely playful. Easy to get the front wheel up, pop over stuff. Reminds me of my dirt jumper I used to have. Descending so far has been pretty good. I probably should have inflated the front fork a little bit more because of the steeper head angle, with a little more weight over the front. But I haven't had an issue so far. I am running Cush cores in the wheels with the Maxxis Recon tires, Recon Plus, in a 27.5 by 2.8 with Orange Seal Endurance sealant. And I'm running 15 PSI roughly front and back, maybe 16 in the back. And then I've got a mixture of SRAM SX components with SRAM XX1 Axis components, just to see how well it works on the cheap stuff. So I have the Axis shifter and Axis rear derailleur with an SX crankset, SX chain, and an NX cassette eagle. And it still is the best shifting I've ever had.
see what this bike does climbing. Being over the rear wheel more, I thought I might have an issue climbing, but actually this thing climbs even better than the Big Honzo. It does feel like the front end could come up a little bit, more so than the Big Honzo, because it is a shorter wheelbase, but it really takes your body weight and your body language, or body English, whatever you want to call it. Really works well. I am impressed. I am also running the Trans X seat post that would have generally come stock on the Big Honzo. Swapped it with the customers. My stock one was 170, I believe. He needed something a little shorter. His bike came with a 200 because an extra large. I am 5'10", roughly 32-inch inseam, and on the Big Honzo and this Honzo ST in a large, the 200mm seat post works awesome. That's a 200mm dropper post. Now we climb. And granny gear engaged. And even though this frame is heavier than the alloy I had, where I was running before, by probably 2.5 pounds. Everything else is the same. It feels lighter. Very tricky section here. Standing up in years. Shape. bike really delivers the power to the rear wheel. It's nice. Easy gear. Saddle up the butt. Lean forward. And climb out. Whoa. Sorry, Bonsai. I just got a face full of nuts. Yep. It's a slow, easier climb. Easy climb again. Front end came up just a tad. There. Not much. Okay.
really does feel like this frame just delivers way more power than the big Hanzo aluminum does. I know it's gonna be wheelbase oriented because of that, but it feels significant. Almost like the difference of, you know, riding a basic decent hub versus an Onyx, where it's just direct drive, instant engagement. Here we go. Hello, dear. Is Sansom Park still doable on a hardtail? Yes. really stands to mark this much on a 2.9er hardtail and not the 27.5 plus. Honestly, probably not. I really like the plus size. Again, so far, I'm not missing my full suspension, and I haven't hit my pedals like I was afraid I was going to. All in all, it's a win-win. Win. A little rough there. Thank you. gear. Should have sat down. Barely hit that window there. Much quicker handling than the big Hanzo frame. Sections like this is where I'd be more worried about hitting my pedals, where these little rocks are protruding everywhere. I generally pedal through everything, even through most turns also, but with this lower bottom bracket height, that may not be possible. Depending on the trail, of course. shortcut, but whatever. I'll just take this. I already did it. Too late now. This is supposed to be the more, what, less bruiser of the two, Hanzo and Big Hanzo, but man, this thing's pretty impressive. It really is. Probably ride about the same with 29-inch wheels and 120 fork, so. Face. Okay, here we go. Dumbed down line. Did it more so for getting a little more distance as well as better drainage. I know. Still kind of stinks. This part seems new though. I don't know if I've done this one yet. Maybe I have. Yeah, I've done this one. The switchback climb. Ah. And we'll say this about the Big Honzo. Every time I got on it, I did feel that I was a little more, a little hunched over more than I would like. Where 130 millimeter or 140 millimeter travel on the Big Honzo, I think it'd be perfect for the fit. And once I got to ride it, I got used to it again. But it always felt just a little low in the front. Even the fork was raked out more. And this one, now granted I'm running 10 millimeter more travel than what the bike comes with, I'm not feeling that at all. It feels very, like, the cockpit just feels awesome. I don't feel too low, don't feel too high, it feels good. Almost ran that little guy over. Luckily he stopped. Alright. Just about done with this trail. I do have one more section to go. What used to be a log drop. I forget what they call it now. Full face, I guess. Big time. full face. This thing's fun. That's the first time I've ever cleared any of the... How's it going? Okay. Clear behind me. That's alright. That's the first time I think I've cleared all the doubles on full face without casing it or hitting the very top of it. It felt good. Felt really good. And it's funny. All the parts on this bike are exactly the same as what I was on before. It's just the frame is different. Nothing else has changed. No new hubs, no new bearings, no new tires, no weight savings, nothing. I added weight with the frame, which I guess that might aid in the extra speed downhill. This frame's about 2.5 pounds heavier than the aluminum I was on. But it feels like this bike just carries more speed, which is weird, with the same parts. Maybe it's I'm able to finesse the bike more and get the more easily use my power, keep it going, or pump it, yada yada. Is Sansom Park, except for the white loop, whatever they want to call it, which they've kind of chewed it up a little bit. I'll have to find where all the old trails were later. But this will end our broadcast day.